instead of actually hugging and shaking hands. And then you may be seated. And I would also like to thank each of you for joining us. We're glad that you're here. We also welcome our online viewers. And just, it's a joyful day. I love singing that particular hymn. Now, I do have some announcements to just share briefly, well, not so briefly with you. There's just a lot of things. Our holiday events brochure is out on the table as you would come through the middle doors. So if you're interested in what's going on at the rest of this season here, that is available. We do have a Christmas Eve service. It will be a what we call parish service with our Korean-speaking congregation, with candles and hymns, Christmas hymns, and reading of scripture. And on the 25th, which is a Sunday, we will have a worship service, and that will be a really casual family service. In fact, we're all invited to wear pajamas instead of, you know, clothes. And I actually bought matching, I hope they arrive in time, matching onesies for Scott and Dalen and myself. Okay, so PJs in worship. And no sermon. No sermon. It's going to be a story for kids. It's going to be a family service, not an adult service. And then Sunday, the 1st, is again January 1st. It's another Sunday. We will have our covenant renewal and Holy Communion at the rail, where we can come again and sit and commune with God that way. Now, before I go any further, I've already had it observed to me that we have extra musicians in the band, and we do, and I would like to turn it over to Barb to introduce our guests.
Thank you. We're really excited to have a friend that was with us a few years ago, and it's been a while, but we welcome Evan Marshall on the mandolin. He taught us about starting a tune with two taters, so that was really fun. And we also have a returning guest that you know, Holly Pyle, on vocals. And someone new, we have a new friend today that we met, and he sounds wonderful. You'll hear him throughout this service. This is Jesse Olima on the fiddle. And the difference between a violin and a fiddle is what?
How you hold it.
Nope, the music that you're playing. So today he's playing fiddle. I also don't want to forget our wonderful musicians in the band who are here every Sunday,
yes.
And it's such a joy to make music with them. Tim Coates on guitar, Ricky Positino on vocals and percussion, Alexis Barevsky on the bass. And lastly, I want to talk to our, and show some love to our choir who donates their time and their energy all throughout the year. Please help me thank Andrew and Jean and Diane and Jenny and Joanne and Peggy and Kathy. Thank you.
We could not do this without Barb. I mean, there's so much work that goes into this. Barb, we love you. We love your dedication.
Thank you, Ricky.
During the rest of the service, so this is incredible for me. Anyway, we also have welcome cards if you are visiting with us for the first time. They're in the pew pockets in front of you, so we invite you to
second candle.
The second candle burns with love that God will prepare our hearts to receive the new life in Christ.
Why won't we light the third candle?
Light the third candle as a
We are thankful and celebrate the joy of this refreshing rainfall of college students returning home for the holidays, even of wet dogs who shake water all over our homes when returning from outside. We are thankful and celebrate the homecoming of Brittany Griner this week and pray for those who are still unjustly imprisoned both here and abroad. We are thankful and celebrate the joy of federal legislation that recognizes the rights, the love, and the marriages of all. We continue to pray for the dignity and safety of all. We are thankful when joy comes each morning. But there are many who do not feel this joy. Some might try, and others have given up trying. Where is the joy for us? So we pray for the lonely, that they might find comfort in another's touch. We pray for the downtrodden, that they might find relief from their burdens. We pray for those wrestling with depression, that a light of calm might bring them peace. We pray for those dealing with stress, that they might find courage to let go. Pray for the grief-stricken that they might experience the newness of life that you bring. We pray this week for the families of Sandy Hook and all those impacted by the devastation of gun violence, that they may find peace and solace in their remembrance this week. And we ask that you hear our private petitions for those on our hearts. May joy come to the world, O God, that we may grasp some of that, not as a commodity to be hoarded, but as a gift to be shared with one another. We wait for Emmanuel, God with us, to come into our hearts once again. May we experience your love and joy in new ways as we turn in love to each other and share our joy. Now, with the confidence of God's children, let us pray together the prayer that Jesus taught us, saying, Our Maker, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation.
We've all experienced that first holiday season without
our special bluegrass cantata. Bluegrass music emerged as a genre about 100 years ago, but it has roots that maybe date back all the way to the 1600s with folk traditions that were brought by Irish and Scottish and British folk immigrants who settled in the southern, southeastern United States, namely Tennessee, Kentucky, Virginia, West Virginia, and the Carolinas. The style we know today was developed in the 1930s and 1940s by musicians like Bill Monroe, which that last song was by, Earl Scruggs, Lester Flatt, and Doc Watson are some of the names of the musicians who blended this folk music with blues and gospel influences from the Mississippi Delta. The songs are often about the daily lives of common people. The high and lonesome sound of the vocals were meant to be heard across hollows and hills and lifted up to the heavens, reducing the distances and isolation of country and rural life. The mournful melodies and tight harmonies and uplifting instrumental solos form a whole that we felt was right for the Christmas story.
For many years, the prophets had told the people about the coming of the promised Savior. This great leader would teach and preach and reach out to everyone, especially the poor and needy. The mountains and valleys would once again ring with promise, justice, and peace would rule the world. The Persian Magi from the Nativity stories undoubtedly were exposed to these prophecies. They may have heard the writings of the prophet Balaam, who lived near Persia, and wrote this in Numbers 12:17.
I see him, but not now. I behold him, but not near. A star shall come forth from Jacob. A scepter shall rise from Israel.
A scepter, or star, is a celestial body. The translation in Greek is aster. And it's mentioned 24 times in the New Testament, including the second chapter of Matthew, where the Magi, wise men, traveled from the east to Jerusalem. Some suggest a natural explanation for the star of Bethlehem, with theories ranging from a supernova to a comet and an orbital line of planets. Christians see the star as a miraculous sign to mark the birth of Christ, the star that fulfilled the ancient prophecy.
What does it mean to us in this modern day? Perhaps the light is there to guide us toward what we are hoping for the presence of God among us.
The beautiful Star of Bethlehem was composed by R. Fisher Boyce in the 1930s while living on a dairy farm in Plainview, Tennessee. Boyce could not concentrate in the house because of the noise made by his 11 children. So he walked across the road to his barn for solitude. The humble farmer, who was also a music teacher, said he looked upon the words and tune as gifts from God.
Oh, beautiful star of Bethlehem.
recognize more and more people as our neighbors, even when they are different from us. We embrace differences and understand that darkness and light depend on each other for their existence. In the fullness of diversity and unity, we experience peace. Hear the gospel from 2 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 11.
Finally, brothers and sisters, rejoice. Strive for full restoration. Encourage one another. Be of one mind. Live in peace. And the God of love and peace will be with you.
God extends love and peace to all. And we at CVUMC welcome all to experience it. The broken, the whole, the wounded, the doubting, the weary, the fearful, and the sure.
Mary Chapin Carpenter captured this invitation so well in her new song, Come Darkness, Come Light.
Come darkness. guide us when we are expanding our capacity for love and widening our circles of community. Wherever we are feels like home, and we are ready to celebrate with joy.
We would like to close our cantata with a popular bluegrass tune written by Tex Logan, but made famous by the great Bill Monroe, who, the father of bluegrass. And this is a tune that's been recorded many, many times. I just listened to a version by Dolly Parton. You gotta check that one out. This one is Ricky Skaggs' version, and it's entitled Christmas Time's A-Comin'. And it's got a really catchy chorus. So we're gonna project the chorus, and when you hear it, you can jump in and sing along, because that's what it's all about.
Yeah.
and Robert Plant tune. You might look that one up. Joy to the world.